Yeah, hi everyone. I hope you had a nice Thanksgiving break and were able to recharge your batteries a little bit for the last 2 weeks in this semester. Yeah, unfortunately, the semester is slowly coming to an end, but hey, look at the bright side. I hope you learned a lot, and also the most exciting stuff is still ahead of us. No, I don't mean the final exam, but your project presentations. I'm really looking forward to see what you have built based on the content we covered in this class. So I'm really excited to see all the creativity and yeah, all the things you have done with the machine learning knowledge that you gained. So yeah, what's gonna happen in the next 2 weeks is in this week I'm gonna try to cover model evaluation 5, performance and evaluation metrics. So here my goal is mainly to broaden your horizon a little bit, looking beyond just classification accuracy and error. So far we only talked about classification error. Now we are also going to see some other metrics for evaluating machine learning models. I hope that won't take that long. And if it doesn't take that long, I will also try to cover feature selection a little bit. I shared some material with you for self-study because, yeah, I knew somehow we are probably not getting to this part, and I don't want to cram everything too full because I know online learning is also a little bit is a little bit more challenging than in person. And so in that way, I don't want to make your life harder by covering even more topics in a shorter time. And I know you also still have a lot of things to do. There's homework 3 due on Friday. I think it's Friday. It's December 4th. And then, yeah, your project presentations on December 6th. I mean, the videos. So, in that way, I don't want to cram this week too full. And then there will also be no quiz this week because, yeah, I really know that you are busy. And yeah, what's going to happen then is for the project presentations next week, I will prepare Canvas pages where I embed the presentations, and I will also prepare a quiz format where we can then vote on the projects for the project awards for the most creative project and the best oral presentation and so forth and the best visualization. So there will be 3 project awards that will be determined by you by voting. So in that way, I think that will also be fun. So I will set that up then for next week. So next week there will be no lectures, but everyone is encouraged or highly recommended to watch these videos. There will be points for filling out the surveys. And I think it's only fair also, yeah, to watch each other's lectures, or not lectures, but presentations, and then we can have discussions on each presentation or questions on Piazza. So I will also try to find a way, maybe not Piazza, I will think about this a little bit more. I will try to find a way that it will be convenient also to ask the speakers some questions if you have some. I think that would be fun to have some interaction. So one more thing before we get started with lecture 5 here is the course evaluations. So our department asked us instructors to remind you to fill out the course evaluations. I know you are super busy, but it would be really nice for us to to hear your feedback about the semester, how the semester went for you. And especially because everything was online this year, it may be different from a regular year, and it would be really valuable to get your feedback for that. I will also post the links for the course evaluations on Canvas, so it would be nice if you fill them out. But if you don't fill them out, there is no penalty for that. It's just nice if you would do that. And so with that, before I make the introduction too long and don't have enough time for the main lecture, let me then get started. And like I said, good luck with the presentations. I'm really looking forward to that, and I'm also gonna watch Piazza extensively this week. Today was a little bit busy because our TA had his prelim exam, so he's also my research student, and the good news is he passed his prelim, so that's also really good news. So I think it's a good week, and I'm looking forward, to teach you about performance metrics and then seeing your presentations next week. All right, let's get started then. Yeah, we are already at model evaluation 5, so the focus of model evaluation 5 is on performance and evaluation metrics. So in particular, we will be talking about different metrics for comparing machine learning models and algorithms. Instead of just using classification accuracy and classification error, we are going to talk about things like F1 score, precision recall, and so forth. So yeah, we have come a long way in terms of model evaluation. We covered the basics, starting from bias variance decompositions, to understand overfitting and underfitting. We looked closer at the common technique, the holdout method for dividing a data set into a training and a test set, and some I would say pitfalls with that if we are not careful. And then we also took a look at how we can construct confidence intervals. using the normal approximation method. And then we talked about resampling methods, for example, repeated holdout, and also the bootstrapping, for which we can then also construct confidence intervals, like empirical confidence intervals, which can be recommended over the normal approximation, especially if your data set is small. The bootstrap will probably give you better results. And then we went on to cross-validation, where we talked about recommended methods for model selection. And in last week's lecture, we talked about certain statistical tests for model comparisons, but then also for algorithm comparisons. For example, using the empirical method of nested cross-validation, which is an extension of the regular cross-validation. Although I am not aware of a particular paper showing the superiority of using nested cross-validation, it's something that is commonly accepted in the field of machine learning in among practitioners, that nested cross-validation is usually the method of choice for algorithm selection. And then in this lecture now, we are going to focus on the evaluation metrics. So when we are going to talk about techniques like precision, recall, and so forth, these are all just metrics that will be compatible with all the methods we talked about before. So instead of, for example, doing grid search and cross-validation with classification accuracy, you can do the same thing with optimizing precision or optimizing recall, the F1 score, and so forth. So in particular, what we are going to talk about in this lecture is first the confusion matrix. So this confusion matrix will be a little bit different from the McNema confusion matrix we talked about in the last week's lecture. So here we are going to talk about the traditional confusion matrix, from which we can derive metrics such as the false positive rate, the true positive rate, and so forth, which will be useful later when we talk about the receiver operating characteristic. We will also talk about precision recall and F1 score and Matthew's correlation coefficient and the balanced accuracy, which can be helpful if we have class imbalances. So if not each class is equally represented in a data set, then for example, the balanced accuracy can be useful. And then lastly, we will be talking about extending binary metrics to multi-class settings. So the balanced accuracy, this is the only one here that is a multi-class compatible metric. So precision, recall, and F1 score by definition are only for binary classification problems. And that's also true for the receiver operating characteristic. But we will see different approaches for extending these metrics to multi-class settings as well at the end. Okay, so with that, the next video will get started with a confusion matrix.